What is going on, everybody? Hope everybody is having a good Monday. It is time for some more battles. Today, we kick off the show with the 1v1 showdown. Making his debut, it's Gene from the God Hand games. I believe it was PlayStation 2. And he'll be squaring off against Berserk's own guts. Let's send it to the Steel Cage is the stage I had selected for that one. And well, apologies again for not being able to upload over the last few days. Been dealing with a slight flu, still a little bit under the weather. But I should be able to get through the battles pretty good today, I would say. Well, Gene, will he have the powers of God in his hands today? Or will Gut's super sword be able to keep him at bay early on? Bang! Bang again. Gut's getting absolutely owned by Gene. Gene's defense able to deflect most of Gut's. Gut's knocked into the corner again here. We don't see Gut's job out many times here, but Gene is absolutely combo heavy here. This could do in Gut's. Round one is essentially over. Yeah, just like that. Well, Gene definitely living up to his God Hand tier status here. Well, round two underway. The lighting in the cage was affected there, but seems to be back to normal as Gut's trying to force a third round. Gene able to break through his defense. And so far, Gut's unable to land a single blow. Unable to cut through and slightly hurt Gene's defense. But Gene essentially 2-for-2 in this one. Finally, Guts finds his opening. And will this just be an endless onslaught from Guts here? Looks like he's going to work here. Are we going to see a third round being forced? Our mighty Berserk Swordsman refusing to let this one go here. Guts trying to get the punch combo going. Sliding. Ooh, Gene sees an opening. Big punch combo. And that's it. Guts couldn't force the third round. Gene takes it in consecutive back-to-back rounds. And Gene is our winner. A successful debut. And I can see him causing chaos in the singles division there. Seems to be pretty strong on his defense and one of those characters that kind of waits and strikes at the character's most least opportune time. Or I should say his opponent's most least opportune time. As for Guts, well, win or lose, I'm sure he'll be back better than ever in the next battle. So it's not really a loss for Guts, just more of a setback. He'll be back stronger than ever, folks. Trust me when I say that. But we have reached the end of our first battle. But we have another 1v1 battle coming right up. And our next 1v1 battle is underway. It's going to be Captain Falcon squaring off against Mr. Satan. Let's throw it to the steel cage. And will it be F-Zero or minor Dragon Ball characters? I guess Hercule Satan played a fairly big role in the series.
Get ready,
let's see if he has powers today or gets absolutely blitzed by Captain Falcon. And while our world's martial arts master actually holding his own with Captain Falcon, at least he was in the early portions, as Captain Falcon has combo heaven. Big punch combo, but it looks like Mr. Satan may have broken his wrist. A grenade from their landmine explodes. And, Captain Falcon has his hands full with this battle. Mr. Satan actually taking a lead here. Big combo connects there. Looks like Satan was powering up. But Falcon interrupts with the big combo sends him to the other side of the cage there. Falcon kick connects. Falcon, ooh, almost gets hit by the baseball combo. Wow, Mr. Satan takes that jetpack combo, crashes down into Captain Falcon. The Falcon punch connects, and yes, and Hercule trying to kick around here. And the Falcon kick connects there, big uppercut. And this one is competitive as it was, a pretty interesting round one there. Captain Falcon manages to take it. I can't believe it. I thought Hercule had it. Well, round two underway. Will Mr. Satan force a third round? Early on, getting absolutely owned in this round. Captain Falcon all warmed up as he stops signing. Apparently, no defense for the Falcon punch kick combo here. Captain Falcon has whittled down Hercule's health about half here. And finally, Mr. Satan trying to get back into this one. Gets hit with a big yes there. Jetpack combo connects there. And don't count Mr. Satan out of this one yet. He's going to have to be pretty perfect here. And, well, that should do it, folks. I believe that is Captain Falcon winning with an ultimate here today. Well, that is a game, exactly. Along with the entire planet, apparently, here. Captain Falcon wins, but apparently has killed himself in the action. Little too much power on that punch there, as this game's winner is Captain Falcon there. Absolutely obliterated Mr. Satan there with that final devastating Falcon punch there. Basically destroyed the entire arena, and from what I understand, it's already been reconstructed. And we have time for one more battle. That one is coming up right now. And our last 1v1 battle of the day is kicking off. It's Luke Skywalker, the Jedi Master, battling Colonel Sanders. Let's send it to the steel cage for this one here. As will, we've seen Luke a few times. I mean, he's hit or miss. Definitely better now that he's cut Yoda's doubles partner going solo here. And well, Colonel Sanders, a tough draw for anybody.
The Force is what gives the Jedi his power.
Well, hello there. And, well, Luke Skywalker. Trying to have, Leia come out there help him out. And early on, our Jedi Master has a little bit of an advantage over the Colonel here. Apparently, Colonel is not using the Force, unable to hit Luke right now. And Luke getting all over. Kind of keeping Colonel Sanders at bay here. Some of his forced unleashed powers there, as well, Colonel Sanders still unable to land and hit the Jedi Knight here, and Luke slowly but surely, I don't see how, but he took a little bit of damage in there. Luke sending the Ewok out there, was that wicked the Ewok, and finally Colonel Sanders finding a little bit of offense here. Luke has just found his lightsaber combo here, and the Jedi Knight, calls out Han Solo and the Millennium Falcon. Huge blast, and the Falcon takes out Colonel Sanders. And there we go. Well, you get the rare win quote. I don't think we've ever seen Luke get a round win quote like that. Well, round two underway, and apparently Colonel Sanders not taking kind to that first round loss. He is no pushover, and he's showing Luke what happens when you underestimate. It's the thousand chicken wing barrage here. Luke's health is down to a quarter, and just like this, the Jedi Knight has figured out that you cannot underestimate the powers of Colonel Sanders. As it's finger-licking good, it's a three-rounder here to close out the show. Let's see who's taking this battle. Luke, well, trying to get Leia to come out there and help. Does not matter, as, well, Colonel Sanders passes Luke, throws him up to the side of the cage here, keeps juggling him around here. Infinite combo. Oh, 14 hits, but Luke's health in big trouble. Finally, I thought maybe Luke was going to find a little offense. Still, Colonel. Big, huge, severe health advantage. Well, we got more force than Luke's power. Finally, Luke getting a little combo heavy here. Colonel Sanders is able to interrupt that, and Luke down to his last little quarter of health, and that's it. After an impressive first-round showing, Colonel Sanders, with relative ease, disposes the Jedi Knight in two consecutive rounds. And good chicken once again. A good victory for the Colonel. And I certainly hope everybody enjoyed Monday's 1v1 battles. I will be back tomorrow, Tuesday, with some more fights. Probably 2v2 Tuesday. That sounds like a recurring theme we'll be doing here. And, yeah, I'll have fights probably the rest of the week unless this cold flu takes a turn for the worse. But I certainly hope everybody enjoyed today's battles, and I hope you'll tune in tomorrow. Until then, thanks for watching, everybody.